Chicago hoists one that goes on out to center and drops near Cronwall. Cronwall lays it back ahead, and it's clubbed back into the Jalmerson corner. He's able to play this one short of that. Fires it along, but it is shrugged down by Zetterberg, then played further by Boland. DATSYUK could not hold it. It comes to Cronwall at center. Last one that nubbed right back toward the corner. Burrowing in there was Franzen. Carries his man around behind as Cleary tries to come up with it. Oduya gets it there. Staggers down, but gets a pass on. Battled for by Brolin, shouldered from behind by Cleary, and we get a halt to play. .123 to go in the third. And where will they? We have a tripping call that has been assessed here. And Zetterberg is the man who is coasting over near the penalty box.
Well, the play was along those right wing boards. And right there, the stick around the foot, the right foot of Johnny Oduya, who did a really good job there of getting back to his feet after he was taken down on the initial forecheck. It drew the penalty.
Three goals by the Blackhawks in the third period. Angled off the short glass and out. Barring an extreme oddity, too early to pull the plug on the United Center ice yet. It will need to be ready for a seventh game. Oh, and then down goes Erickson. He was flipped there by Hossa, and a penalty coming up. 1:01 to go here in the third. It will need to take a Boston Lightning-like strike, as they had against Toronto, for this to get even.
Yeah, Eddie, that's not a real clean play by Marian Hossa, who's usually a very clean player. Not the kind of play you want to see at this juncture of the game.
Looking for the puck and caught the left skate of Jonathan Erickson, and now Jimmy Howard back to the bench. Well, a 5-on-4, five skaters against four with the goaltender out.
A minute and a second. DATSYUK on the tie-up with Taves. They go rushing after it. Red Wings are able to outman now with Cleary. Giving it on now to Franzen. Back for Brunner. He scores! And it's a one-goal game.
We talked a lot about face-offs in this series. It's one of those 50-50 pucks. Taves wins it, but Pavel DATSYUK chips the puck. And Cleary gets it. DATSYUK to Brunner, wide open. Then, and it's a one-goal game.
The vision, the creativity, and the awareness of Pavel DATSYUK. And Eddie, you talked about it. Doc talked about it. The quick strike of the Bruins against Toronto. Eddie, you said you'd never give up at any point in these playoffs, and you're absolutely right. And now we got a little track meet with 51.7 seconds to go.
You got a timeout. Coming by that side of the ice, Mike Babcock and the Red Wings. Remember, it's 4-on-4 hockey still. And with the anticipation, if Detroit can get control of the puck, the extra attacker will come on the ice with Howard on the bench, so they will have a man advantage with 51.7 seconds remaining, down by one.
DATSYUK and Cleary get the assist on the goal by Brunner, a club-leading fifth goal of the playoffs at 19:08.
There better be a lot of people turning around to come watch this last 51.7, because there are a lot of empty seats masquerading as fans right now.
DATSYUK to draw with Kruger at center. Howard at the hash marks, out of camera range right now. Taken by Cronwall, drifts on back, and it's deflected. Cronwall has to circle around behind, and Howard must go back to his crease. Now he moves onto the bench. It's onto the stick of DATSYUK, 37 to go. That one deflected out of play into the Hawks bench.
Good stick there from Marcus Kruger. Big time play to break up the rush to the middle of the ice.
And Eddie, how about the confidence Joel Quenneville all season long in Frolik and Kruger, two depth players who have really found a niche playing for Joel Quenneville. Outstanding stick. You're bang on Kruger.
Datsyuk and Taves again. Cronwall and Bronson, and then Cleary tangling across the way with Hontsus, the extra forward, in case Taves gets chased out of the draw. Howard back to the bench, is replaced now by Brunner. Puck lobbed all the way down and wide of the net, and will it be icing? Yes.
Johnny Oduya iced this puck.
He did not know. He did not know that they were at even strength.
He did not. You're 100% right, and he's talking to Jalmerson right now.
Jalmerson, good poke check. There's Oduya going for the empty net, but did not realize that his team was at even strength. So the faceoff comes all the way back.
The draw of the year for Chicago. Datsyuk in on this draw with Taves. Taves, while falling, cleared it back down. This one will go over the end line for an icing. 15.6 to go.
Eddie, is that leadership there from Taves, though? That's second, third, and fourth efforts.
That's one of those 50-50 pucks that ended up in behind. Datsyuk won it, but Taves found the angle and have the ability to be able to dive and get that puck out.
Same two men again. Spike to the corner. Jalmerson fired it back around. It won't go to the end this time. Cronwall back in the last eight. Nicholas Cronwall with five to go. Leads it on out and hands it across. Brunner gains the zone with it. He'll have to shoot quickly. It is blocked wide, and that takes care of the game. There'll be a seventh game coming up in Chicago on Wednesday.
Shots on goal in the third period. Chicago has eight.
It has been a three-period game, or at least a full 60-minute game for a century. And through two periods, it was looking great for Detroit to eliminate Chicago and pull the plug on the ice at United Center, but it's not happening. It will be a seventh game coming back there.
Depth players came up large, and Corey Crawford, after giving up a goal from about 45 feet out, a knuckler from Anderson, he really settled in, Doc, and made a couple of real key stops and high fives all around from the captain. But depth players jumping in large for the Blackhawks. Bickle in the third, Hontsus in the third. And then Frolik with the penalty shot, backhand goal.
And that turns out to be the winner in the game, Pierre with Jonathan Taves.
Thanks very much, Doc. I'm just letting Jonathan get his gloves off. What's the best way to describe that win by your team?
Relentless. Never. We're not giving up. They were flying in that second period when they went up a goal. It's tough. It's a good building for them, and but we knew that we were going to hang in there. We just needed one goal, got that energy back, and everyone responded top to bottom.
Jonathan, what was talked about between the second and third period? Because you guys looked like you came out on fire.
Well, I think you definitely get emotional when you get in those situations where you're down a goal, and it's do or die. Your season might be over, and we just know that we got a special group, and we don't want to pass that up. This is a great opportunity this year, and we got to give it everything. So we did that in the third.
Corey Crawford gave up a rough goal to end the second period. Did anything get said to him before he came out for the third? Because he was stellar at the end of the second.
No, nothing had to be said to Crow. We know that he was going to bounce back. He's been unbelievable for us in every single game in the postseason, including the regular season. So we knew that he was going to come back and play great the way we needed him to in the third, and no worries there at all.
Wednesday's game seven, what can we expect?
We're going to come at them just the way we have in the last two games. We're going to lay it all on the line. So we've got to use our billing. That's an advantage. And that we're going to give it all we got.
Good for you. Thanks for doing this, Jonathan.
Thanks, Pierre.
Doc.
Final score in the game. 4-3 Chicago. Ready, Olczyk, Pierre McGuire, Doc Emrick, and now the Bud Light postgame with Liam, Mike, and Keith.
Doc, thanks so much. Detroit. Drama definitely delivered. And now this original six showdown will be settled in a game seven from Chicago. Mike Milbury and Keith Jones will break it all down. And we will take you back to the Joe for post-game reaction from both clubs. And of course, we are looking forward to game seven of the California Clash tomorrow night out in Tinseltown. So far this postseason, the Sharks and the Kings have both been perfect. More next on the Bud Light Post-Game Report.